In this video, you'll see how to configure AWS Control Tower to send Amazon Virtual Private Cloud, or Amazon VPC, flow logs to Splunk. With this solution, you can deploy an account factory customization blueprint that creates an Amazon Kinesis data firehose delivery stream to send VPC flow logs to Splunk. This solution requires a valid Splunk endpoint for receiving data from Amazon Kinesis data firehose, as well as an HTTP event collector, or HEC, token configured to receive the VPC flow log data. We also need an Amazon CloudWatch VPC flow log source type, which can be installed in Splunk by using the Splunk add-on for Amazon Web Services. For our purposes, these prerequisites have been met, and we're ready to deploy the solution in AWS Control Tower. Let's start by going to Account Factory. Let's create a new account. We'll add an account email and a display name. AWS Control Tower uses AWS IAM Identity Center, so we'll need to add our credentials. Account Factory customization is optional. We'll provide the account that contains our AWS Service Catalog products. Once we validate our account, we can choose products to deploy from our Service Catalog portfolio. We'll be using the Splunk Flow Logs product as our blueprint. We'll also specify the product version. Next, we'll specify some Splunk parameters. We'll enter the Splunk endpoint URL and the Splunk HEC token that we created for the solution. Let's leave the default values for the other parameters. Next, we'll specify the deployment region for our blueprint policy. Let's create the account. It takes a few minutes for the account to finish provisioning. Now let's navigate to CloudFormation to check that our Service Catalog product deployed. On the Stacks page, we can see that the first stack in the list creates the VPC flow logs configuration to send the flow logs to Splunk. The stack includes an Amazon Kinesis data firehose delivery stream, an AWS Lambda function, associated rules, and other resources. Now let's test whether the solution works by setting up a new VPC. We'll give our test VPC a name. For the sake of simplicity, we'll create one availability zone with one public and one private subnet. Now we'll create our test VPC. Our VPC is fully created. Now we can view our flow logs. Per the Account Factory blueprint we used, whenever a new VPC is created, the flow log is available to Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose. Let's view the Kinesis Data Firehose delivery stream. Kinesis Data Firehose has retrieved the destination settings for the Splunk endpoint and HEC token. Now, let's generate some network traffic to send VPC flow log data into Splunk. To do this, we'll launch an Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2, instance. But first, we'll need to create an instance role in Identity and Access Management, or IAM. Let's go to the IAM dashboard. We'll create a new role. We'll select the EC2 use case. We'll add permissions to access AWS Systems Manager. Let's proceed to the next screen. Finally, we'll enter a name and create the role. Now let's navigate to EC2 to launch the instance. We'll give the instance a name and use the Quick Start configuration for Amazon Linux. We'll edit the network settings to specify the test VPC we created earlier. Let's choose the public subnet and enable a public IP to be auto-assigned. Under Advanced Details, we'll enter the IAM instance role that we just created. We'll keep the remaining defaults and launch our instance. For our example, we'll proceed without a key pair. Now that our instance is created, we'll connect to it. to generate some network traffic, we'll ping google.com. Now let's return to Splunk to see whether this data has been sent. From the main index in Splunk, we can see that our VPC flow log data has been received. You've just seen how to configure AWS Control Tower to send VPC flow logs to Splunk. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.